I'm Vasily Petrenko, music director of Royal Philharmonic Orchestra, music director of Russian State Academic Orchestra and of European Union Youth Orchestra. But this week I am here in Israel, in Tel Aviv, performing with Israeli Philharmonic Orchestra, an incredible program of Shostakovich and Tchaikovsky. Shostakovich's Seventh Symphony is a monumental piece. It is written in 1941, partly in Leningrad, partly in evacuation in Samara. It had this famous broadcast from the besieged Leningrad. The impression from the people who were listening to it was like, how can you overcome and make a victory against the people who are writing such music? Shostakovich himself spent quite a lot of months in Leningrad prior to evacuation. He was there servicing as a fireman on the roofs, trying to dump down all the fire bombs which were falling on the cities. In the first movement, this famous episode of invasion is built on the several themes. The main one is from Lehar, the Lustige Witwe. It is an operetta which was one of the most favorite pieces of music for both Stalin and Hitler. The second movement is one of the most quiet and silent movements of all Shostakovich heritage. It's almost as if you are afraid of silence, and people were afraid of silence in Leningrad. At that time on the radio were just the news about the front and metronome. So this Leningrad metronome was very famous, and people were afraid that this metronome will stop at some point. And if it will stop, it will mean that the city is surrendered. It didn't happen, but a lot of people were really frightened of the silence. The silence quite often can be much more frightening than the very loud noises. The third movement is Passacaglia. It is written as a memories, as a requiem on the victims. It is written also as a hope for the future. It raises the question, what are those victims were for? And then the last movement, it starts again in a silence, and it's almost as an uprise, constant movement into C major as a key. Key of C major, which comes only at the end of the movement and which is very significant and very bright. It was for Shostakovich and for many other composers the symbol of white light. And for him, it was a hope for the victory of human spirit, the victory of the city, the personal victory. Nowadays, we live in a very turbulent world. We have war, we have many different crises. And we hope that this Leningrad Symphony and many other pieces of music, they'll bring some hope, they'll bring us to the future. We have to live together. We have to be partners. We have to live in love, we have to respect each other, and we have to believe in future with peace and culture.